The Deputy Speaker's directive followed a matter of national importance raised on the floor by the Kira Municipality Legislator Ibrahim Semujunganda, expressing concern of the Minister Otafide's high-handedness, who allegedly stormed Njeru government ranch and arrested a manager who tried to block him from taking over the land.
Verino Kaindo Otafide has grabbed, and in the process of grabbing it, arrested the breastfeeding manager who he did not even allow to breastfeed. But the most important thing, Mr. Speaker, when you are charged with custody and responsibility over a government, if we don't stop this level of impunity, we will wake up one day when, Mr. Speaker, you are also taking over parliament and you will say someone has sold it to me.
Semuju invited the government to prevail over the minister and stop the impunity perpetrated by Major General Otafide.
If I had a way, I would get General Otafide and those who sold the farm to him and send them to Ruzira. Since I don't have, Mr. Speaker, that's why I'm raising this matter here. Can government tell us whether the level of degeneration has reached this far that a minister can go and take over a government farm, arrest a breastfeeding manager, and tell her not to even breastfeed, and then he says, this one, I bought it, I have chased them.
Semuju was reinforced by the leader of opposition, Joel Senyonyi, who gave information to parliament that court quashed General Otafide's title.
This very farm hosts the only liquid nitrogen plant that serves all hospitals in eastern Uganda. So for the minister with so much impunity to grab this farm is depriving ordinary folks of service delivery. Right, Honorable Speaker, if we allow such impunity to continue prevailing, we shall be depriving ordinary folks of service delivery.
However, on behalf of the government, the Minister of Public Service, Mururi Mukasa, asked Parliament to summon Minister Otafide to make a personal statement on the matter.
Then you have Minister for Internal Affairs also raising his own issues. Honorable Mururi Mukasa, such are matters. Because Cabinet Secretariat is under public service, the office of the President, the head of public service.
Really, the best thing would be, in the circumstances, for us to request Honorable Kaindo Otafide, yes, to come up and say something.
The third Deputy Prime Minister, Rukia Isanga Nakadama, informed Parliament that the manager has since been released on police bond and she's back in charge of the contested farm.
The update I have regarding the issue of Honorable Otafide and the government farm is that the manager was released immediately. She's out on police bond, and she is right now in charge of the farm.
The Deputy Speaker of Parliament, Thomas Tayewa, has decided to give the Prime Minister 2 weeks to report back on steps taken by the government to sort out the mess around this road.
Okay, handle this matter and then come and report to this house in 2 weeks' time.
The Parliamentary Committee on Agriculture extensively investigated this matter in the 10th Parliament and recommended the government to repossess Njeru stock farm. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.